listening to HDVR Hot Dog Vendor Radio. Well, welcome back, folks. This is Ben here at LearnHotDogs.com, and today we are going to cover some steam pan question that we received from a gentleman named Leo on the LearnHotDogs.com listener feedback line. If you have a question, comment, sing a song, do a dance. Well, I won't be able to see you do the dance, but get on the listener feedback line. That's at LearnHotDogs.com/feedback.
Ben, how you doing? Got your book. I love it. Haven't been this excited about something in a long time. Read the section about pans. I've got a two-burner cart with no pans. So I'm kind of curious what would be the best setup for me being a newbie. Can you help me out with that? Thanks.
That was Leo that called in with that question. And thank you, for Leo, for the question. But I also want to read his email. He says, "Hiya, Ben. Got your book, reading and rereading it with my highlighter. I must have not been this excited about something like this for a long time. I've got a newbie question for you. I have a two-burner cart with no pans. The section in your book explained them pretty good, but what is the best setup? 3 1/3 size pans is what I'm thinking. I would like to boil in one of them, steam in the other, and the third I would like to set up water for chili and cheese. Could I get 3 small pans for a third item to fit in the third size pan, or just 2? What would they be like, 1/6 or 1/9? Would 2 of the 3 pans be big enough to handle chili and cheese, or should I just go with 2? Would the lid still fit with the 2 or 3 smaller pans inside? How can I steam buns with my setup?" is his final question. That's a good question. And he's talking about chapter 17, which I'll pull that up for you in just a second, from the Hot Dog Save My Life course that I've got. But I've also done some videos online and showing the steam pan setups, but there's always questions like this. And hopefully by sharing this, more of you will understand and be able to convert your setup to suit you better. And so what I'll show you here is, this is, this is on the learnhotdogs.com blog, site. And if you put in the search right here, you can type in steam pans and it will pull up several articles and videos. But if you type in understanding steam pans, you'll find it instantly. But it's this one here. It was done about a year ago, July 13th, 2011, I think is when I put this up. It may have been 2010. Either way, this chapter 17 covers the pan setup. And what I'm going to try to show you here is using this. If you notice, this is a full size pan right here. Okay. That is a full size pan. It measures roughly 12 inches deep and 20 inches wide. What it's showing there, it could be a spillage pan or a normal steam, a normal pan, steam pan. But these others are fractions of this. So anytime you change sizes and you want multiple pans in here, the fractions have to add up to the whole. So this is a half size pan here, right here is a half size pan, and it would take 2 halves to make a whole. Pretty simple math. Now here's a fourth size pan and a fourth size pan, 2 of those to make a half size. So if you wanted, you could take these 3 pans and it would make up this area, or you could take 4 of these and make up this whole area. The problem with 4 size pans, not quite big enough, for a lot of things. They're big enough for, obviously, for condiments and stuff, heated condiments, but not for really for boiling dogs. Most people use a third size pan. That's right here. And the third size pan will allow you to, you'll see that on most carts and manufacturer pages. you can use three of those. So you'd have one, two, three instead of this full size pan. And now if you were steaming or setting these in a bath, you would have a spillage pan here and three of these sitting in the water underneath those pans, and it would create heat, but it wouldn't be direct heat. The direct heat would be under this box. So what he's trying to do though, is he's wanting to know if he uses two of these and then for the third spot. So basically he have one here. Okay. And one here. And then he's wondering about this spot. Can he get three pans in there? Well, the answer is yes. He can use these three pans. These are 1/9 size pans, and 1/9 size pans make up, if you use 9 of them, they'd fit in here, but 3 of them make up a third. So 3/9 size pans could go here. So he'd have this like this. Don't you love my pretty drawing? So that'd be his 3/3 size pans and 3/9 size pans and 2 1/3 size pans, which would accomplish what he's trying to do in pans, but it's not going to solve his problem with, if you remember from his email, let's see if I can pull that back up real quick. He said that he's wanting to, let's see, boil in one of them, steam in the other. And the third, I would like to set up water for chili and cheese. What he's talking about is like a water bath. Like I explained to you just a second ago. And so boil in one, which means it's going to need to be a direct heat, steam in the other, which means it's going to need to have a false bottom or something. And then the water bath means it's going to have a steam pan, spillage pan under it with those three little pans. So it provides that water bath. The problem is they don't make a spillage pan that just is that size, you know, a third size spillage pan. So it creates a problem because these pans won't really fit inside of here. See how they grounded this area? That's causes the problem. So he can't really put, three third size pans in a third size pan. He can use 3 9th size pans to replace a third size. And he could even put it in a spillage pan. But if he's got a spillage pan, like shown here, spillage pan, and then, 2/3 size pans and 3/9 size pans, he wouldn't be able to boil really anything in these pans because it'd all be heated water and it may come to a boil, but it's not direct heat. So it's not going to boil the water in this pan, is the problem. So if he puts water in this third size pan here to boil and he's got water under it, it won't happen. It's just impossible. So what he could do is, and something, let me tell you real quick, you can come down here and these are false bottoms and you can put these false bottoms inside of pans to create steam. So let's say you don't have a spillage pan, and you need one as far as, I'm going to raise this up a bit so you can see this better. Let's say you don't have a spillage pan and you're using direct heat all the way across and the fire is coming up straight underneath this pan. You could have, let's say you wanted three of these to replace this and the fire was coming up underneath them, but you didn't want to boil in one of them. You wanted to steam. You would use a false bottom to go inside of there. And that would solve that. Now, I hope this is making sense to you. And if it isn't, just ask me or send me a message or something, and I'll try to do a better job at explaining it. I know it's a lot of information, but I'm trying to be thorough. So some people will feel like I'm beating a dead horse. But the gist of this is he's wanting to have two of these and three of these, but boil in this one. And that's not going to be possible if he's going to use these as he wants to use them. And so realistically, the only way that he can do it, and it's not going to look exactly right, is if he puts no big steam pan, okay? He gets 3/3 size pans, and he puts them in place of that. Then he's got direct heat coming up underneath from the fire onto these three pans. One's boiling, one's steaming if he uses the, if he uses this handy dandy false bottom. And then these three pans he could buy and stick in here, but they'll stick out a little and they can still have lids on them. So it's not the end of the world, but they will stick up about an inch. And that's the drawback. Now, when you go pan shopping, if you buy the ones that they say, they will actually say non-jamming or zero jam, which means they're tapered. Well, the problem with those tapered ones is you can't put, like if he was putting these pans in here, they'll stick up even higher on a tapered pan. And if you buy just a regular third size pan, he can probably get these not to stick up so high. And that's really all the only options for him. Now, his other question was, is this big enough for chili and cheese? Well, it's kind of a relative question. If you're selling 2 chili dogs a day, then it's plenty big. If you're selling 500 a day, not going to do it. But it comes to a matter of filling it. And see, he doesn't want these over direct heat. He wants them in a bath, sitting over water so they never scorch. And so what you could do here is constantly be filling it. A ninth is still a lot of food. So you could get a lot of chili in that and a lot of cheese in that, and it wouldn't be the end of the world. And it's not ideal. If it was me, I'd use 2 of these and not 3 of these. That way you'd have a lot of chili, a lot of cheese. And you could still put these two inside of here and they'd stick up some, and it's not going to look the best, but there's a lot of vendors that do that. The only alternative really is once you can get a cart that has a bigger steam table set up, like the big dog cart, you know, it has this extra large steam table. So you could do this and this and this. So it does all of that. And then you've got the option to be steaming, boiling, and water bathing all at the same time, which works out better. I wish they made some spillage pans smaller, but I haven't been able to find them. If somebody does find them, let me know, because I can't find them anywhere and never have been able to. I think that covers the pans. I want to tell you this false bottom. If you notice, it's real thin as far as it's got holes in it. And what happens is you put about a 1/2 inch of water in the bottom of your pan, and they make these for half size, third size, and full size. But if you're using it for the third size, like in his situation, he'd pour about 1/2 inch of water in the bottom of his third size pan. The water would sit under these holes. It would boil, steam would come through and heat his buns. If he doesn't have room to do the buns, along with everything else, he can always lay them in the sun. But what I prefer is, even if he's using the steam area for his dogs or holding dogs after he's boiled some, or he's holding sausage, he can still throw the buns in on top of it, of the sausages or dogs sitting here. And as long as this is always going on high, it's going to provide enough steam to do the bun, to steam the buns in seconds, literally seconds, 30 seconds at the most. And he'd have nice, hot, steamy buns. That sounded horrible, but that's the truth. Now, if you're steaming these, steaming through here, you're going to have to stay vigilant in keeping the water in the bottom. Otherwise, you'll scorch your product that's sitting on top of this. So if you've got sausages and dogs laid all over the top of this, you'll scorch it and ruin it, and it won't be as good. While we're here too, I'm going to show you what this is. This is a steam pan, which would normally fit inside of a spillage pan. So this steam pan would fit up here into here. And now that picture's showing a half size, so it would take up 1/2 the space, and you'd have water in this pan. This, it would heat up and the steam would rise through. That's different than a false bottom, and it allows you to keep things separate, but the false bottom are perfect for the smaller pans. And when you don't have a spillage pan. Like in his case, he won't be using a spillage pan. He'll be using regular pans with a false bottom. I think that about covers it. Well, folks, that about wraps it up for me here at LearnHotDogs.com and Hot Dog Vendor Radio. I thank you for joining us for another show. I hope that helped you, all that information about the pans. If you have a question or comment, please go over to the listener feedback line at LearnHotDogs.com/feedback. Also, if you want to help me earn Google juice, please subscribe to the blog. It's the only way you get updates. You get updates, okay? Tips, tricks, all kinds of secreties, Pentagon type stuff, all right here at LearnHotDogs.com. Now, I told you about subscribing, right? Click the subscribe button. It's on the right-hand side.